explaining Microsoft System Center licensing. This is Ralph. Ralph is head of a mid-sized company and really proud of the firm's success. However, he also knows that the company's success in the future is strongly dependent on the reliability of its IT. And this department is having significant problems in terms of the increased business requirements and keeping up with them. Therefore, his IT director, Tom, proposes using Microsoft System Center. With the help of this management solution, the IT department can react before malfunctions arise. This way, the employees are able to tackle their daily business in a straightforward manner. He can also plan his resources more optimally and operate the systems automatically. Ralph has been won over. With Microsoft System Center, he has found the ideal solution to increase the productivity of company IT. However, Tom would also like to achieve an even greater degree of virtualization, which would then reduce his infrastructure costs. Of course, the number of virtual servers has to be able to be quickly adjusted to the respective requirements. Ralph is happy with Tom's plan, but he is still unsure about how the product is licensed. Does the increasing amount of changes, and above all, the constantly increasing number of virtual servers, mean an increased level of complexity in administering the licenses? Tom is able to put his mind at rest here. As Microsoft System Center uses a processor-based model for licensing, this works quite simply. Licensing takes place for the processors on the physical servers to be administrated. With the data center edition, the number of virtual servers is irrelevant. One license always covers two processors. And the best part of all, the management software from System Center is already included and does not have to be licensed separately. Furthermore, Microsoft System Center contains SQL runtime. No extra licenses are required for this database either. Microsoft System Center is even available in two different editions. Both editions have identical functionalities. They differ only in terms of their virtualization rights. While the standard edition is primarily suited for use on physical systems and administering them, the data center edition is suited for operating several virtual systems. Needless to say that Ralph chooses the data center edition. After all, this has the objective of creating a higher degree of virtualization and thus achieving a cost-efficient IT department. Tom is delighted. He now has the complete picture and is able to deal with his administrative tasks and complete them in a straightforward manner, irrespective of whether he is administering the physical or virtual servers. All types of monitoring are now assumed by System Center, and thanks to endpoint protection, concerns about viruses and malware are now a thing of the past. Ralph is satisfied too. With Microsoft System Center, he has found an all-in-one solution, making IT a real factor for success. All these features with a low license cost. For more information on licensing Microsoft System Center, visit us on the Internet